A former human rights commissioner alarmed over yet another proposed budget cut for the agency. Under the Budget Department's 2023 spending bill, the Commission on Human Rights would only get 878 million pesos for next year. That's 8% lower than the CHR's 900 million peso budget for this year and way below the agency's proposed 1.6 billion peso spending plan. Former CHR Commissioner Gwen Pimentel Gana warns a budget cut would gravely affect services of the agency.
Ang epekto yung sa delivery of the services ng CHR. Kasi syempre, sabi ni ED Jackie, maapektuhan daw ang transportation. Eh anong equivalent to? Syempre yung investigative arm namin. Even yung promotions, you know. So maraming mga services na maapektuhan. At napakalungkot isipin na bakit ba nila pinagdidiinan, nabawasan ang budget ng CHR. Eh, di ba nila nakikita na para sa proteksyon ng lahat. Kasi kahit sila, mambabatas, you know, covered sila.
Another former commissioner meanwhile says the government should immediately appoint new CHR officials. The CHR is left without a chairperson and commissioners since May this year.
There's a global standard for national human rights institutions accreditation. Ngayon, just to say, now we're up for accreditation already in March 2023. Pagka natenga pa ang appointments, ay malaking dagok po yan sa komisyon. Kasi pag tiningnan mo, trabaho rin ang gobyerno natin to enable check and balance mechanisms in our country. Pag hindi yan ginawa, anong ibig sabihin yan about your governance, di ba? Na akala ko ba, bukas ka sa kritisismo, bukas ka na pakinggan ang mga hinaing ng tao.
Turning now to the budget deliberations at the Philippine House of Representatives, lawmakers flagged the Public Works Department over its unutilized funds. House Deputy Minority Leader Bernadette Herrera D. says the funds could have been used for the agency's unfunded projects.
Meron po tayong unreleased appropriation na 39 billion and an obligated allotment na 48 billion noong 2021. At ang pinakamasakit po eh, nag-remit tayo ng overall savings na 3.4 billion noong 2021. Eh para po sa amin na nagkakandara pa mapondohan ang mga priority projects natin, masakit pong tignan na nagbalik tayo dahil hindi natin nagamit.
But DBWH Secretary Manny Bonoan explains the agency side, saying there were many sources of funds, including savings.
The savings is in standby budget, budgetary allocation for augmentation of other projects, Madam Chair. So these are being used actually to augment what is the additional requirements for the deficiencies for ongoing projects. We have utilized this actually to augment our requirements for maintenance, for foreign assisted projects, and for preliminary engineering requirements. I think yung unappropriated or unallocated unreleased funds, Mr. Chairman. These are probably some of the projects that are awaiting yung the releases for the SARO, because these are the projects that have been labeled as for later release.
The Labor Department will now supervise a Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA. That's according to an executive order signed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Based on that order, Labor Chief Bienvenido Laguesma will sit as chairperson of the TESDA board. TESDA was previously supervised by the Trade Department.